A lot of times people think that they need a fancy camera to make great looking cooking videos. Well, in this video series, I'm going to share with you the step-by-step guide to filming and editing professional videos on your phone. What's good, everyone? My name is Philip Lemoyne, and I'm actually a full-time cinematographer, but I love to cook. On this channel, I'm not only posting cooking videos with some of my favorite tried and true recipes, but I also share tips and strategies to help you make your own cooking videos. So if you're hungry for great tasting food or that YouTube money, spank that subscribe button. A couple of months back, I posted a behind the scenes video of me breaking down how I shoot my cooking videos and cooking show content. A lot of people pointed out all the gear I was using, but I wanted to prove a point that you don't need all of the expensive stuff to make great looking videos. I'm gonna break down this process into a 5-part series. Part one is gonna cover some of the gear that you're gonna wanna consider investing in that can take your camera phone video from amateur to pro. Part two is gonna cover some tips for filming. I'll cover techniques, camera settings, as well as explain how to shoot efficiently so that way you're not spending tons of time sifting through footage when it's time to edit your videos. Part three is gonna be ways to capture and create awesome thumbnails. And part four, we're going to go over how to edit your videos on your phone. Part 5, I'll also show you how to upload your videos to YouTube and maximize your reach. So we have a lot of things to cover, but before we get into filming, I wanted to go over a few inexpensive items that you'll want to consider investing in first. All of these things I'm about to recommend will only cost you a total of about $150-ish, but it will take your camera phone footage to the next level for sure. The very first thing that I would recommend investing in is going to be audio. I personally think audio quality is more important than video quality when creating content where you'll be teaching someone how to do something, like prepare food. Your audio will immediately stand out once your video begins.
And having crappy sounding audio will instantly take your great looking video from professional to amateur.
There are a number of different styles of microphones at different price points to consider when upping your production value of your cooking videos. If you want to learn more about audio for cooking videos, I created a whole nother YouTube video breaking down the best microphones for cooking videos and which ones I personally use and all the different ones I would recommend. In this video, we're going to be using the most budget-friendly microphone that I could find, which is the PowerDeWise Lavalier lapel microphone. I got this off Amazon for around $35. It does need to be plugged into your camera, but it also comes with an extension cable. This will allow you to get further from your phone, but still be able to attach it to your shirt. The next thing I'd recommend investing in is going to be a tripod and a phone holder. These two things are not 100% necessary because you could always prop your phone up on some boxes or something to film yourself, as well as hold your phone in your hand while you're filming, while you're cooking. This does get a little bit difficult and sometimes can get frustrated when you're trying to film your food while at the same time not burn it or chop it or cut it and it's all moving around all over the place. There are a number of tripods out there on the market ranging from like $15 all the way to thousands of dollars. I would recommend finding a tripod made out of metal or aluminum. You'll want to stick with something that has legs that are locked with clips, not the screw to tighten or loosen. Clip locks are much quicker to adjust and you don't have to worry about your camera falling over because you forgot to tighten one of the legs all of the way. You'll also want to find out the max height the tripod can go up and break down. Since you'll be filming yourself prepping or cooking food on your counter or stove, something that can get up to about 50 or 60 inches would be ideal. An adjustable center column is also great because you can quickly adjust the height of your phone without having to do each leg at a time. You'll also want to pick up a phone holder. The one that I would recommend, I got on Amazon and scored it for $10. I love this one because it's made out of metal and it feels super solid. It has the option to attach a quick release plate to it and attach it to your tripod if it has one. It's also super easy to adjust your phone's orientation from vertical to horizontal, as well as angles for your shots. One bonus thing I'd consider but would increase the cost of your tripod is going to be finding a fluid head. This isn't necessary if you plan to do mostly locked off shots, but a fluid head will allow you to get smooth panning or tilting movements with your camera or phone. I'll put a link to a couple of the options in the description below. And the very last thing I would recommend investing in is going to be lights. One of the best ways to create a professional looking image is to have good lighting. I created a whole nother video breaking down lighting equipment and techniques. So if you want to learn more about this topic, be sure to check that video out as well. I'll put a link in the description below or I'll have a card pop up. The free option for good lighting is to shoot near a window with lots of natural light. However, this may not be an option depending on where your kitchen is located. And if it is, you'll have to deal with the light changing when the sun pokes in and out of the clouds. And you'll also have to schedule your filming in the daytime. This is why I would recommend investing in a light kit. You just have more control of your lighting environment. An inexpensive kit that I found on Amazon that had great reviews on YouTube is the Favitech or Fovitech fluorescent lighting kit. This is a super simple light setup with everything you need to create good looking soft light for your cooking videos. I'll have a link to this and a few other options in the description below. So there you have it, people, the three things I would recommend investing in before you begin shooting. If you'd like to dive deeper into how I produce my cooking videos and how you can do it with your phone, make sure you check out my full in-depth cooking course. I'll be sure to put a link in the description once it's ready. I hope that you guys found value in this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a like and also check out my Facebook group, YouTube Cooking Creators. I'll put a link in the description. We're a community of YouTube cooks sharing our experience with hopes to grow our channels and make income with our cooking videos. Let me know if you had any questions in the comments below, and I'd love to share all the information and knowledge I have to help you make better looking cooking videos and grow your YouTube channel. And that is it for this part of the series. In the next video, we'll be going over some tips for filming your cooking videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. I have a ton of other videos up and in the works to help you create better YouTube cooking content, along with more great tasting recipe videos. If you want to catch those when they drop, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And thank you so much again for watching. Aloha.